Gino, I'm already afraid. With your behavior, I could not anymore tolerate this. Yesterday, you kicked me. Today is a Sunday and we're gonna have an ample time feeding all the animals that are here in the farm. And I'm so glad that our African lovebirds have adjusted to their new environment. And we're gonna be installing also our water system. And then we will transfer our second batch of our ducks to the bigger pen. Hi guys, it's a beautiful day once again and welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Well, today is a very busy day because it's a Sunday and during Sunday we're on a lockdown and we have an ample time to improve whatever needs to be improved here in the farm. And I'm so glad that in our previous videos, we were able to have a good discussion about how to take care of these African lovebirds. And I'm so glad that many of you have shared your experiences and I hear your advices and thank you so much for the tips that you are giving to us for us to become successful in this African lovebirds farming. I'm so happy with your sharing and we will now make a small update about the conditions of our African lovebirds. And also, I would like to let you see our low-cost budget cages for the African lovebirds. Actually, I made use of the wood as our materials for the cage system and I hope this will work because I ran short of budget, really. That is why I just opted to use the low-cost material, the woods, for our cage, and you will see that later. And also, we are going to improve the water system, the water connections here in the farm, and we will do some fixing of the pipes and of course putting some faucets for us to have convenience in our system. We're giving water to our animals and we're improving the water system. And also, we would like to inject vitamins to our goats and then we will transfer our second batch of our ducks to the bigger pen. And I think that they are now good to be transferred in a bigger space. And they will join the first batch of ducks that are already settled right there. And also, we will feed our chickens. We have so many updates about our chickens since the time that the coop had been flooded due to the typhoon. I'm so glad that they're recovering. Some of them died, some of them got sick, but we have successfully treated them and they are well right now. So for the meantime, let's go into the pen of our African lovebirds. So guys, this is the condition now of our African lovebirds. And I'm so glad that we have identified the pairs already. They are actually paired. It's very easy to identify whether they're a pair or not because if they are paired, actually, then they will always get along with and they are so close with each other. They are kissing and this is my way of identifying whether it is a pair or not a pair. And you will see that they are already in place, but I would like to remind you that this is not actually their permanent cage because as what I have said, I'm intending to make a colony breeding. And some of you have doubts about the colony breeding because it's difficult to trace the lines, but maybe we can do this of course, we have to exert effort and we have to make a marker so that inbreeding will not happen in our breeding system. And you will see that they are already very noisy. And I just learned that these African lovebirds are actually adult ones, and very soon they're gonna be laying their eggs. And you will see that they don't have yet nesting boxes, and that's the thing that we would like to fabricate there in the colony cage. So guys, we are here now in this breeding coop, and we are about 60 or 70% completion. We fast-tracked the construction of this. Actually, this is already late, but then still, we are trying our best to complete this within this month of November. And we will make sure that by December, we're gonna be seeing our African lovebird in this breeding cage. And you will see that this is big, actually. This is much bigger than the cage that we have fabricated for the parakeets, because this has a measurement of around 8 feet. And then we have the width of actually 10 feet and 12 feet in length. And we will use the recycled materials. We use the galvanized iron because, as what I have said, I'm running short of my budget. And we will use the welded screen. It's a costly material, but we have to invest because we cannot also afford to just allow the predators to come inside and eat our birds. So we have to fix the four corners of this cage so that these predators could not come in. So this is a work in progress. And tomorrow we're gonna put the roofings and we're gonna be making updates about this. And for this month, I'm sure that we're gonna complete this one. And by the month of December, we're gonna be seeing a beautiful, very beautiful colony cage for our African lovebirds. And just a while ago, we were too busy then fixing our faucets and the piping systems because I want to improve our water system here. From the tank, we have the outlet here, outlet there. I made this because it's near to the parakeets and the cage of our African lovebirds. And I'm also trying an effort to fix some faucet right there. Maybe we can put some 3-4 faucets for the Azolla, for the breeding pen of our Rhode Island, and also for the rabbits. And also we would like to make some faucets for the fish pond and over there at the ducks and the chickens. So these are my dream, and maybe we can finish that today or maybe a couple of days from now. So now we will inject vitamins to our goats. Actually, they are in need of these vitamins, and we're doing this regularly so that their health conditions will be improved, especially during this rainy season. Come on, let's go. And we will inject our goats. And it's part of our system to give supplements to our goats. Sometimes we use vitamins mixed with water. And the usual thing that we do is we will inject regularly this iron. And this iron is actually called Bilamil. And this is good for the goats. And for the bigger goats, we are giving 2.5 ml. We used to give this whenever it's rainy season because we would like that their immune system will really be boosted. So we will now inject, and we will inject first 2.5 ml to Tarzan, the biggest goat here in the farm. So we will also give some shots to Pedro. So we have just done injecting vitamins to our goats, and now we will proceed to the transfer of our ducks, and you will witness this, guys. This is now our major activity, because we know that these ducks can already survive in a bigger space. So we're gonna transfer them because they're already very congested in the pen where they are temporarily placed. So we will now put our ducks over there. Come on, please witness this, guys. So I'm so excited now to transfer our ducks to the bigger duck pens. Actually, this is the second batch, and I'm looking forward to have another batch, which is the third batch. And all in all, we have more than 500 ducks as our starter for this duck farm. And we will now begin catching them. And please watch this as they're gonna be thrown or transferred in the bigger space. I don't know what would be their reaction, but I'm sure that they will like the place because it's big and it's so spacious, and the condition is so windy, and it's good for the ducks really because there are available water. So we will now start catching them, and we will bring them to the new environment. Come on, let's do this. Oh, the age difference is 3 months, and this is actually now my concern because they might be trampled upon by the bigger ones. But I think this is the initial reaction, but since the place is big, well, maybe they can adjust. And this is what is good about the ducks. They can just easily adapt the new environment. You can see over there, the smaller ones had a separate group, but I believe that they will easily adjust in this new environment. So another batch here. Okay. Okay, go. Go, go. No. This is a big space for you. Okay, be careful. Be careful. since we already have vast of experiences about duck farming, so I'm confident that we can manage this farm. In the next couple of months, we're gonna be putting some housing over here so that they can just get inside and lay their eggs during dawn, and this is gonna be an exciting activity. You know, duck farming is a good business if you are just able to know the basic about duck farming and the molting period, the giving of the food, and also the time that you're gonna cull them. So the culling, the molting period, and the laying of the eggs, the rearing of the ducks, and the hatching of the eggs are very important factor in duck farming to consider. Hello, Vicky. Please, stay. Please. Gino, I'm already afraid. With your behavior, I could not anymore tolerate this. Yesterday, you kicked me. You know, guys, Gino could not be tamed anymore. He cannot just be complacent with the behavior of this ostrich now. This is actually a wild behavior. Gino, come on! All of a sudden, he will just throw a kick. It's very hard kick. And this peacock also. I would like to hold you. What happened? You want to eat? You want to eat? Nice! You want to eat? You're amazing. You're amazing. Come on! Imagine, Gino is 10 feet and we could not anymore be complacent because he will suddenly kick. He will throw a kick. It's very painful. It's very dangerous. I don't know how to tame you, Gino. Your behavior is now different. He's attracted to dark colors. Oh, this is not your food. This is a plier. Okay? Oh. So it's feeding time, and we're gonna feed our native chickens. Of course, we will give first to Gino. Gino cannot wait. Okay. Hi, Gino, I'm afraid of you. You're already very big. Gino has unpredictable temperament. Okay. Wait. I know you guys are hungry. Oh, come on. And there are some others who were rescued during the flood. Those which are severely affected were caged, and we'll feed them also. Come on, we'll feed them. We will recover soon. Okay. Smaller ones are here. How are you guys? Oh, it's good to know that you're recovering. When we had this great flood, all the sticks were soaked with water and they need to be placed here in this elevated cage. Some of them died. And that's the thing that I am so concerned about. When the sudden typhoon comes, it's very painful for a farmer. I know that you can also relate with me. Some of you are also experiencing the same. What about this one? You still have your food, vitamins, okay. Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay. That's good. Okay. What about here? Plenty of them right here. And I pray that they will grow big. They will not die. Of course, they're already treated. Ah, sit. I treat them with probiotics. If you wanted to know about the mixture of this, oh, what happened? We can also share in our future videos how to culture probiotics on our own. And it's very helpful. Okay. Okay. Oops. Okay. Water is here. Water is here. Oof. It's tiresome, but it's very enjoyable. Feeding all your pets. That's all that we can share with you so far. It's a tiresome day for this vlog. We have done so many things here in the farm. It's self-fulfilling, self-satisfying. And I would like to invite you, if you are not subscribed to this channel, may we humbly ask you to please subscribe and hit that notification bell, because we are uploading videos every 3 to 5 days, only here at Dexter's World!